Shalom, I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat, and welcome to a special outreach update from Israel. As we're getting close to the Feast of Trumpets, Yom HaTorah, the Lord's Feast, we understand, as believers in Jesus and Yeshua HaMashiach, that it's pointing to the second coming of Yeshua HaMashiach. Jesus said in the book of John, chapter 10, verse 27, "My sheep listen to my voice. I know them, and they follow me." We understand that the sound of the trumpet is the voice of the shepherd calling his flock. We understand that in the Bible, the trumpet represents God's voice. God is speaking to us through the Feast of the Lord, because in the Feast of the Lord are multiple fulfillments pointing to the second coming of Yeshua HaMashiach. And we eagerly wait for that trumpet to blow and call his bride home. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 52. "In a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet, for the trumpet will sound, and the dead will be raised imperishable, and we shall be changed." We pray that the people of Israel and the nations will hear the trumpet, will call on the name of Jesus, Yeshua HaMashiach, as their personal Savior. Our ministry, Messiah of Israel Ministries, had a big giant campaign this week and blasted over 35,000 Bible CDs in the mailboxes south to north of Israel. We have been receiving many, many phone calls, emails, and people wanting to hear more about the real meaning of hearing God's voice and hearing the sound of the trumpet. We wrote many Bible passages in the CDs, including Psalms 89, verse 15. "Blessed are those who know the joyful sound," and said, "If you want to know the joyful sound of the Lord, contact us." The result? Hundreds of people have been contacting our ministry. The people of Israel are hungry for the truth. The people of Israel want to hear the joyful sound. They understand that religion doesn't do it. There has to be something more. Yad Lachim, the anti-missionary organization in Israel, founded to deprogram believers, are shaking from these campaigns. They're continuing to launch radio broadcasts all over Israel, telling people, don't open your post boxes. They're trying to steal your soul. It's backfiring on them. Jews are opening their post boxes. They're listening to the CDs, and the Holy Spirit is opening their eyes. We give all the glory to Yeshua the Messiah, Jesus. As we continue to preach the gospel and follow up with the people that are hungry for the truth, continue to stand with us in prayer for the lost sheep of Israel. Continue to pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Psalms 122, verse 6, available only through the Prince of Peace, Yeshua the Messiah. As we're continuing to do the follow-ups, continuing to launch the CDs in the mailboxes, we're also preaching the gospel in the streets of Israel, south to north. In this outreach, I met a rabbi called Rabbi Eliezer Nachman. Rabbi Eliezer Nachman approached me in one of the outreaches and asked, "What are you doing here asking people to hear the joyful sound? Are you a cantor?" I told him, "I'm not a cantor. I'm just a servant." He asked me, "Who are you serving?" I said, "I'm serving the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob." He then asked me, "What do you mean by the joyful sound?" I turned the Bible to the book of Psalms, chapter 89, verse 15, and read with him, "Blessed are those who know the joyful sound, that they shall walk in my countenance." The rabbi was in shock. The people were listening. The gospel was being preached. He then asked me, "How do you hear the joyful sound? I hear the shofar every day right now as we're preparing for the Feast of Trumpets." And he didn't say the Feast of Trumpets. What he said was the Feast of Rosh Hashanah, which means the New Year, which was invented by the rabbis. It's not the New Year. It's the Feast of Trumpets, Yom HaTorah, the Day of Blowing. I answered the rabbi, "The only way to hear the sound of the trumpet is through the Messiah." I then read Isaiah 53 with him, Psalms 22, Psalms 2, and many other passages. He then asked me, "Who is this Messiah that can give me the joyful sound?" It was almost like he knew, but he wanted to hear the truth. I turned the Bibles to Proverbs chapter 30, verse 4. "Who has gone up to heaven and come down? Whose hands have gathered up the wind? Who has wrapped up the waters in a cloak? Who has established all the ends of the earth? What is his name? And what is his son's name? Surely you know." I turned to the rabbi again as he was silent, and I said, "Surely you know, Rabbi. God is calling you. it's time to turn to Him before it's too late. And what better time than the time of the feast of the Lord? Blessed are those who know the joyful sound. And the reason it says in Hebrew to light the countenance is God wants to shine His radiance on you. Just like when Moshe Rabbeinu, when Moses went up to the glory of God, the Bible says that his face was radiant. God wants to shine that radiant on you. But you need to hear His joyful sound as the shofar is blowing. The rabbi was speechless. He couldn't speak. As you can see in one of the pictures, after reading Proverbs chapter 30, verse 4, what is his name? And what is his son's name? Not only is the rabbi in shock, but he's holding his head. He doesn't know what to do. He knows the truth. I handed him my phone number and told him to call. He left the conversation. One thing is certain, the rabbi and all the people that were there and all those that received the CDs in their mailboxes will never be the same again. And for this, we give all the glory to the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, Aryeh Yehuda, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, Jesus Yeshua. Let's continue to stand together as the one new man, Ephesians 2:15, bring the gospel back to Jerusalem and go home. Until next time, I'm Messianic Rabbi Zev Porat, sending you blessings from Jerusalem, Israel, and we are blessed because we know the joyful sound. Shalom from Israel.